course I'm okay that Star got community service. I didn't want her to go to prison. But then the judge let Todd walk too. Unarmed jailbreak? And, well, you can't be okay with that.
No, I'm not. And my officers won't be either.
And then there's the other murder charge. Oh, my God, he'll probably walk on that too.
No, we're not finished here, Red.
No, but we are so far behind, Bo. I mean, there's still the Victor Lord murder case too. We've got to nail him on that because right now, Thomas Delgado is pleading guilty to the murder of Irene Manning, and everybody knows that Todd did it.
Is that it?
Yeah.
You sure?
No. Yeah, I'm done.
Look, I have not closed the book on the Victor Lord murder case. We will find the killer.
Whoever that may be.
Look, you're not the only one who's ticked off that Manning is still out there walking the streets. Mayor Finn, she stopped by first thing this morning.
Oh, yeah, I bet she did.
I told her that without Jack's statement, we don't have enough evidence.
I shouldn't care about that. We killed her photo op.
You bet we did.
Oh, God. Okay, I'm about to say something that you can never repeat. Okay. Not even to me. I miss Dorian Lord as mayor.
I know. Me too.
I told you Mayor Finn would be yanking your chain over this.
No, what you said is that she was going to fire me.
Yeah.
She did.
This is so personal. If the press ever found out what went on between the two of you before...
No, nothing happened before.
And that's her problem.
I think this is more about her election.
Oh, which makes her an even bigger idiot than I thought. But does she realize how popular you are? Your approval rating is double what hers is.
I pointed that out.
And what did she say?
She rehired me.
Why am I not surprised? I mean, I'm glad you got your job back, of course.
Of course. And I have until election day to find Victor Lord's killer. And if I don't do that, then the mayor promised that she would fire me.
Well, then we just have to get all the evidence we can to convict Todd, right?
I have McBain and an entire unit working on Victor Jr.'s murder. We will chase every lead.
That's twice.
What?
That you haven't said Todd is guilty. Don't you think he is?
Are you going to get that?
What's up? You're kidding. On my way. Judge just dismissed Delgado's plea.
Why?
Because Todd Manning just confessed to killing Irene Manning. I'm going to finally get to put him away. You know it.
I was caught off guard. I came in thinking this thing was open and shut.
Oh, it never is when it comes to Manning, believe me.
Yeah, I'm figuring that out. Next time he's on dock, I'll leave him to you.
Well, hopefully if all goes well, there will be a next time.
All rise.
We're on record in the murder of Irene Manning. Welcome, Ms. Buchanan. It appears we have a second confession. This time from Todd Manning.
Nadia, I need to see all of John's files on the Victor Lord murder. Everything. Every piece of evidence, I don't care how small, okay? Just as soon as you can. Okay, thank you. Yeah.
Commissioner?
Hey, just got a call from Buchanan Enterprises. Thought you might want to hear about this one.
This has become an ugly habit from your office, counselor. We have defendants trotted into court on the flimsiest of evidence or with questionable confessions. I can't count how many hours this court has wasted.
Well, Your Honor, with all due respect, in this case, Mr. Delgado was found at the crime scene with the murder weapon in his hand, and he confessed. I wouldn't call that flimsy evidence.
Except you got it wrong.
Yes, and we're here to amend our error. Now, Mr. Manning has confessed.
But he has not
pled guilty. Your Honor, if you'll excuse me, my client has not been charged. And if the district attorney continues to be so misguided as to pursue this case, we will plead not guilty.
Based on what?
Self-defense.
On what evidence?
The bullet hole in Mr. Manning's shoulder. Your Honor, Todd Manning went to meet Irene Manning unarmed.
So he says. We have no evidence to that.
There was only one gun found at the crime scene. And it's the same gun that killed Irene Manning. And it's the same gun that fired the bullet that lodged in Todd Manning's shoulder.
Oh, the phantom bullet. When Mr. Manning turned himself in and he claimed to have been shot, there was no bullet in his shoulder. And there was no way to confirm.
Mr. Manning received home care. We can produce the bullet and forensics will prove that it was fired from Irene Manning's gun and that it was removed from Todd Manning's shoulder.
That would seem to be compelling evidence.
With all due respect, Your Honor, there is a chain of custody issue with the bullet. And if it was so clearly self-defense, then why did Mr. Manning run?
Because he was in shock. Irene Manning had just informed him that she had killed every member of his family. A bomb did go off at Victor Lord's residence. Todd Manning heard that explosion. He was out of his mind with grief.
And that's when he shot Irene Manning, after the bomb went off. Not in self-defense, but in a rage. Because that's who Mr. Manning is. A vicious sociopath.
Miss Buchanan, it seems you've already convicted Mr. Manning in your mind.
Your Honor, the district attorney is clearly biased against my client.
It's still up to her office to make this call. Do you intend to prosecute Mr. Manning for this murder?
Extortion, I can arrest you.
Are you kidding? He just assaulted me.
You're lucky he didn't kill you.
Say it again, I will.
Knock it off. Get out of here, Wentworth.
You're gonna regret this, man. Get out. Your mistake. Don't forget this.
No.
It's a big mistake.
Self-defense means an imminent threat to one's personal safety. If Mr. Manning killed Irene Manning for any other reason...
You mean like the bomb that Irene Manning set that could have killed every member of Todd Manning's family? And your husband as well, who was also there. All this after years of having subjected Mr. Manning to physical and psychological torture and unlawful imprisonment? Please! Put me in court with this set of facts.
Just grab any defense that's around.
I've already stated what happened. It was self-defense.
And the evidence as stipulated overwhelmingly supports a verdict of self-defense. If you intend to prosecute Miss Buchanan, you better come very well prepared and with something more than I've heard so far.
Your Honor, before I make a decision about the filing, I'd like to ask Mr. Manning a question. I understand that when he confessed to killing his mother, he said... That's not all I've done. What did you mean by that?
Mr. Manning, let's go with the truth the first time, shall we?
Take my life, Victor. Take yours. You did something unforgivable.
What did you do that was unforgivable?
I let Tomas Delgado confess to a crime that he didn't commit.
That's it. That's all you got.
I was gonna let a guy rot in jail for the rest of his life. That's not bad.
Not in your case.
Maybe not. Maybe not. But I'm trying. I'm trying to do better. You know what? It's Nora's case. If she wants to throw me in jail for that, that's up to her.
Well, Madame District Attorney,
Given the totality of what you've heard today, do you feel you have the evidence to successfully prosecute Mr. Manning in this matter? Because at this point, given the amount of time he's already spent in jail on false charges, your office is opening itself up to allegations of false prosecution, not to mention a whopping lawsuit this city can ill afford.
No, Your Honor, the Commonwealth will not proceed in this manner.
Mr. Manning, you're free to go. We're adjourned.
All rise.
It's on.
You know, before that jerk came in, I actually thought I was doing better.
Are you packing?
Yeah, it's kind of hard to tell, huh? But I am out of here.
Why?
I got into it with Clint.
No.
It's good. I'm giving it all back.
All what?
Everything I had Clint sign over to me from before the transplant. The house, the money, the stocks. You should be happy about that, by the way. It turns out I suck as a corporate tycoon. I probably saved all of Buchanan's inheritance.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, but why?
I only wanted the money so that I could get revenge against Victor and Jack for what happened to Gigi. It turns out that wasn't a good plan. Or a good way to spend my life, or Shane's.
No.
Now that Victor Lord did, it doesn't matter anyway, so I'm giving it all back. What?
I'm proud of you.
Surprised?
No, not really. Did my brother at least treat you decently, or did he treat you like something stuck on the bottom of his shoe?
No, he was actually pretty decent. He wants me and Shane to stay in the mansion.
Wow.
Yeah. When he found out that we were headed back to the carriage house, he said he knew it would be difficult to live where we were with Gigi.
My brother actually said that?
Yeah. It felt like a lift. Like I could breathe a little. So I came back here, started packing. Started thinking about Halloween, spending it with Shane. I'm throwing this party for Natalie and Brody. I was actually looking forward to something. And then that sack of dirt cutter comes in here.
All right, hey, look. You want to sign a complaint? I'll arrest the guy.
You know the worst part? Worse than him saying that Gigi was still alive? Until he asked for the money. I actually believed him. I've been trying so hard to get it together. Be a better dad for Shane. Move forward. The minute that Cutter comes along and dangles a little bit of hope in front of me.
Balsam, this could happen to anyone. Anybody who loves someone and then lost them would do the same thing.
I just wanted it to be true. So bad.
Well, congratulations. All of your clients walked today. Do you get a bonus for that?
Justice was served.
Was it?
Nobody likes a sore loser, Nora.
Oh, Ted, is that what you think this is?
You want to see Todd in jail so badly that you can't control yourself. And the judge saw that.
Yeah, I do think that's where Todd belongs.
Todd did what he had to do on those docks. Otherwise, Irene would have killed him. Justice was served.
Ted. Your husband was gunned down in cold blood by a man who's walking around free, thanks to you. Still think justice was served?